Welcome to another tutorial in my tutorial series AutoCAD 2D Technical Drawing. And in this tutorial, I would like to show you how you can use those commands like rotate, mirror, move, scale, and align. And for this, I have this little task. And here you have this let's say goal pattern, and we have different forms. And we have to use those commands to change, or let's say to fit that, to make those forms that they fit in this, let's say, goal pattern. Okay, and we have different tasks. At first, we should use rotate command and the mirror command and so on. Okay, let's do it. Right now, we are in task one. And here we have to use the rotate command. So for this, we can go to the home tab, and here in the modify group, we can find, among others, the rotate command. This is this one. And let's turn this off here, because if this is turned on, then we cannot easily see our command line. So let's turn off the screenshot. So now it's better to see. And here, and now I'm in the standby mode of my command line, and it asks me to type a command. And of course I can type it, but I would like to only click at the icon here. I click at this rotate command. Oh, by the way, if you hover over it and you keep it for a while, then you see this small explanation. And if you need more information, just hit the F1 key on your keyboard. And then it will open up the online help, and you can read more information. Yeah, this is mainly interesting concerning all those rotation parameters. Yeah, because not every, but the most of the commands here in AutoCAD, they have some command parameters with which you can adjust the command to your purpose. And of course, I cannot go through all the parameters we have. This will take too much time. I will just introduce some of the parameters here in this task. Okay, hit rotate command, and then it asks me to select the objects. Of course, you must tell AutoCAD what you would like to rotate. And now I have this at my cursor. I have this small rectangle, and with this I can click on the objects I like to rotate. Now I clicked at this object, and it asks me again to select some other objects. If I'm done with this, just hit enter on your keyboard, and we are in the second subcommand of our rotation workflow. And here we have to specify the base point. So for the base point, we have two possibilities. By the way, the base point is actually this point here, which is already in the right position and which we can use to turn around. Yeah, and this is this point, but to specify this point, we have two possibilities. We can use the grid, because the base point is at the grid, so we can enable the snap mode of this grid, and then we can snap on it, or we can of course use the object snap. Yeah, the object snap is here. We have enabled endpoint and intersection, and let's turn this on and use the object snap if we want. But this is just to mention it. You can also use here the absolute coordinates. Yeah, you can see this is 150 for X and 50 for Y. But of course, this is I just mentioned it, but this is actually makes no sense. But if you want, you can also hit the coordinates if you know it. Yeah, here in the command line. In our case, as I said already before, let's use the object snap, and I click at this point, and now I can turn around this point. And and now it asks me for the angle. Yeah, if I know it, I can enter it. I don't know it, of course I can. Actually, I know it, because this is the angle between this line here and this line here, and this is 180 degrees. Yeah, I can of course enter now here 180 degrees, but I can also just click here using the object snap or the grid snap. Or what I can also do, if it's 180 degrees or 90 degrees, I can use the auto. Turn on the auto, you see, then I can, if I have no object snap or no grid snap, then I can use also the auto. If it's 90 degrees, if it's somehow 90 degrees, yeah, this I can also use. And just to mention it, and now just click when it's in the right position to finish this command. Okay, so far about rotation. Let's, and this was task number one. Let's go to task number two. Turn off task number one and turn on task number two. And now we should mirror it. Yeah, it looks similar, but in this case, we don't want to rotate it. We want to mirror it. Now I would like to select my object I like to mirror before. And now I hit here at the mirror icon. And as you see, now it doesn't ask me to select the objects because I selected them already before. So there's no need for AutoCAD to find out what I would like to mirror. It just takes the already previous selected. It takes only the selected objects. And now it asks me for the mirror line. Yeah, I've forgotten to show you. If you hover over it, you see this small explanation, and here you see that there's a need for a mirror line to for this operation. And the mirror line, for if we want to draw the mirror line, let's draw the mirror line just to make it easier for you to understand. I can use for the mirror line, wait a minute, I think we have those, so the construction line, and turn off the auto, and this is the mirror line, and it should be between those two points. For this I could use the grid. Let's use the grid snap, and this is my mirror line. I just want to visualize it. Of course, it is not a good way to use those construction lines, because I will show you don't need them, but I just would like to visualize this workflow a little bit, and that's why I created this mirror line. And now let's mirror it. Again, I select this object, go to mirror, and turn this object snap this time off. And now let's create the mirror line. And I don't use this line. I just wanted to show it to you. Actually, there's no need. And now I can click at two points of my mirror lines. The first one is this point here, and the second one is some point at my mirror line. For this, I use the grid. Because the mirror line, as you see, goes through my two grid points. And so to specify the mirror line, I just have to click at those grid points. And now it asks me if I like to keep the, or if I like to erase the original object. I say no, because I would like to show you another workflow. So I keep it. And just to mention it again, I don't use this line. This I just use for visualization. Of course, you can also use such a line, but I think if you know to use those devices wisely, then there's actually no need for such construction lines. In this special case, certainly you don't need it. Anyhow, let's leave this for visualization purpose. And now the mirror line uses the grid. But let's assume that we don't have any grid. So we cannot use the grid snap. How can you do this with the object snap? And this I would also like to show you. So let's select this object. Now again, hit mirror, or click at no, not hit, click at mirror icon, and turn off the grid snap, turn on the object snap. And this point, of course, is at the mirror line. For this, you can use the object snap. And another point is in the middle between this and this point. And of course, if you have a construction line, you can use it. But I would like to show you how you can do this without a construction line. And for this, I press the control key on my keyboard. And simultaneously, I press the right mouse button on my mouse. And now we are in the context menu, and here you can create the mid between two points. Let's use this device, and now it asks me for my first point. This is this one. For this, I can use the object snap, and the second point is this one. And now it created this point, which is exactly in the mid between those two points. Which is actually also, I could also use this point. Doesn't matter. And I hope I could show you that there's actually no need for some construction lines, only for such a to use as a mirror line, you can use, in the most cases, you can use those devices. If it's possible, you can use the grid. If not, you can also use the object snap. Okay, do you would like to erase it? This time, let's say yes, and we can delete this line. There's no need for this anymore. So I have shown you in this task number two, how you can mirror something. Let's go to task number three. Turn off task number two before, turn on task number three. And here we should move it, and then we can choose if you would like to mirror or if you would like to rotate it. It starts with moving. I select the object before because it's only one, so it's easier. Let's go to move, and now it asks me for the base point. This is, could be this point here, and I move it to this point. So this point here is already in the right position. And now let's at first do it with rotation. I go to rotate. Now I have forgotten to select the object before. Now it asks me how to select the objects. Of course, I can click on it, but I would like to show you another trick. You can also enter the letter P, and P stands for previews, and then it selects all the previous objects, or not all the which you have used previously in the command before. And now hit enter, and you see now it selected this object, but you can also add some additional objects. That's why I'm still in the selection mode, but let's finish this. And now it asks for you for the base point. Let's use this as a base point. And yes, and now it's not so easy here to specify this because it's not in 90 degrees like last time. The increment is on 90 degrees this time. It's somewhere, this is a randomly angle. So what can we do? For this, of course, we can measure the angle, and then we can enter it. This I'll show you later. But we can also use a reference. Let's use a reference. Click at reference. And if you choose for references, in my opinion, it's always easier if you start from the base point. If possible, use always the base point. So I click at the base point for the reference line. And now it asks me, I can use this reference line or this reference line. Let's use this one. And now I can easily rotate using a reference. And let's undo this because I promised you that I can also show you how you can measure the angle between and then just enter it. We are still at the home tab, and here you find the measurement tools, and here is the angle. And now let's measure the angle, but keep in mind we have to measure the angle between this line here and this line, because this line should be actually here. So let's click at this line and this line. Now it tells me this is 101 degree, and let's hit the right, press the right button on your mouse, and here you can go to reset input. Here we have rotate. You can also use the space bar for the last command, and again press P on your keyboard for the previous object, and enter. No, I finished this, the selection, and now press the base point, and it was 101 degree, so enter it here, 101, and by the way, this is counterclockwise, so there is no minus now, it's positive, and hit enter, and so on. This is finished. If you want, you can also enter the angle. I mentioned it that if you enter angles in AutoCAD, this is always counterclockwise. If you want, you can change it. Where you can change it? Here, go to the A, and there's a small arrow. And here, I think in the drawing utilities, you find units. You can also enter the units command in the command line. And here in the units, you can change it to clockwise if you prefer this. Actually, I never do this. And but if you want, you can. You can change it. Okay, so let's undo this because we can also mirror it. But this is just actually which I have shown you before, but let's do it again. I click on this, go to mirror, and use this point here as my base point, and now I hit the control key on my keyboard and press the right mouse button, and here mid between two points I use those two points to specify the mirror line, And I would like to erase the object, yes. And this is also possible. In my opinion, I think rotation is better, but it's up to you what you prefer. Actually, we have done two commands, yeah, and it took us a while to end up this process. And there's actually a shortcut, yeah, which is a little bit hidden in AutoCAD. I don't know why. And with this, you can do all of this at once, yeah. And this command is called align. You can also align object. Here again, there's a small explanation. Yeah, you need some align points, at least two points, as you see. Yeah, and okay, let's do this together. And I click at this object. I would like to align, and then I go to modify, and here click at the align icon. And now it asks me to specify the first source point. The source means where I start. I will start here at this point, and where should this point be? It should be actually here. Now it asks me for the second source point. Okay, if this point is here, then this point should be here. By the way, it doesn't matter which point you choose, it should be just the right location. Yeah. And here, for instance, I could continue with this one, also with this one, it doesn't matter. Just keep in mind, it should be at the right location. So if this point is here, then this point should be here. And that's all. Yeah. So it's done. You see, with the align command, this is actually, in my opinion, or in most cases, it is much quicker. Sometimes my students ask me, if you know the align command, for what do we need all the do we use all the other commands? Yeah, and of course there are some situations maybe where you cannot use the align commands, and then you can still use the other commands. Yeah, you always have to choose the right command for the right purpose. Okay, this was the task number three. Let's do the last task. I turn this off and turn on the last task, task number four. Here we are. We have some forms, and of course it looks similar to the other task, but you will see there is a small difference. And of course we can move it, and then let's rotate it. So I select this object, go to move, and move it here again to this position. You see this is already here. Again, it needs a rotation. And okay, so let's go to rotate, enter the letter P, hit enter, enter again, and here we use this as rotation point. We don't know the angle, and it's not so easy to click, so let's use a reference. Again, it's better to start always from the base point if possible, and use this as a reference, and it should be actually here. And maybe you have seen this, or you have realized this already. Here, the size does not match, so we have to scale it. Scale is this command. So let's scale this form. So I click on it, and now I enable the scale command. It asks me for the base point. I use this as a base point, and now it asks me for the factor. I don't know the factor. Yet, I will show you later how you can calculate it. No, that's why if I don't know, like in our rotation command, let's use a reference. And here for the reference, I again prefer always start from the base point if possible. So this is my base point. This is my my original line. And this should be the new size of the original line, should be this one. And that's all. And let's undo this, because I would like to show you for the reference, you can also use some other lines. It doesn't necessarily be always the base point. But it's, in my opinion, if you don't use the base point for reference, it's more complicated. And here I can easily illustrate this for you. Again, let's go to scale. Here, this is our base point. And now I go to reference. And this time I don't use the base point. I just maybe this line for the reference. Or if you want, also you can also use this line here. Let's just use this line. So this line, and now I have to enter the new length for this line. I don't know yet. Of course, I can measure it, but I can also go to points. Yeah, and then I can say, okay, this is the old length, and this new length should be this one. But you see, it's a little bit more complicated. Yeah, if you if you don't start your reference from the base point. But it's still possible, and maybe there can be some situation where this workflow would be better than using the base point. And let's undo it again, because I wanted to show you how can you calculate the factor if you want. So for the calculation, we can use the internal calculator, which you find here. This is already here. I have it already here at the right, at the left side on my screen. Just turn it on. And here you see I have done this already. So let's do it again. How can I clear it? So, okay. So to calculate the factor, we have to measure this line and divide it by the length of this line, and then we have this factor. And here in the advantage of this calculator is, of course, you can also use an external calculator, but the advantage of this calculator is that you have already the measurement tools here. So you don't there's no need for you to enter this manually all these values. You can use those measurement devices. So let's start. I use this measurement option and measure this line. And you see, now it's in my calculator. Now I use the divider here, and now I measure the other line. This is this one here. And you see, there's all the values. They are in the operation here. And now let's calculate it. And here we have the factor. And now if we have calculated it, now we can do the scaling. Again, go to scale here, click at the object you like to scale, right button on your mouse. To finish the selection, now specify the base point, and now here for the factor, I can now enter it using my keyboard, but it's better if you just right click on the value here in the calculator and paste it to the command line. And here we are. There's the factor. You only have to hit enter on your keyboard, and the scaling is done. Yeah, so far about scaling. And there could be also a shortcut. Yeah, remember in the task number 3, there was a shortcut to combine all those commands. And yes, as a matter of fact, we can also use the align command to combine the command move, rotation and scaling. But you have to take something your consideration. Just turn off the calculator. We don't need it yet. So, okay, let's go to the align command. Align, select this object. And the first point could be this one. This should be here. The second point is this one. And you remember last time we used 3 points. But last time there was no need to scale. If you have to scale, then only use 2 points and now hit enter. Only 2 points. This is the trick. Hit enter. And now it asks you, do you want to scale it? And I say, yes, I like to scale it. And you see, here we are. But it could also happen that if you use only 2 points, that the object is not in the right location. It could be also at the other side. Yeah, you can also end up, let me show it to you what I mean, Miro, that it looks like this. Yeah, this could also happen if you use only 2 points, because actually to orientate it in the right position, then you need actually 3 points. If you use 2 points, we only use the 2 points, and it could be lay here or here. In our case, we had luck, it was at the right position, but it could be also here. Then, of course, you have to rotate. You can rotate, you can also mirror it. Yeah, but anyhow, you have only 2 commands instead of 3. Yeah, but if you have luck and it's in the right location, you can also use other points. Yeah, this is also possible. Okay, so far about the commands move, rotate, mirror, scale, and align. I think the best tool here is align, but take in consideration that it might not be always matched to your purpose. Sometimes you might also use those other commands. I thank you for your attention, and maybe see you in another tutorial.